Alright, good morning everyone. It is a beautiful morning. And a little cool, but later today it's supposed to be in the 70s. So I think it's going to be great weather for putting down, gluing down that vinyl plank. And I'm going to make a Home Depot run this morning for a couple more supplies. And then start working on the floor. One of the things I just realized, actually, I'm always remembering or realizing things in the process, and that is the base, the wood base that I, you guys saw me with the plywood that I created and bolted to the floor. Well, right now I drilled holes in the floor, and two holes for the wood base, and it's going just through that thin metal. So what I want to do is I want to buy like a square piece of steel, drill holes in that, and put that on the underside of the floor, because I know the floor, if it's anything like the ceiling piece, is very easy to bend, actually. So that way it'll give more structure to that battery base and also the seat base, because there's two holes that I had to drill for the seat base as well. So and I'll show that hopefully today. Hopefully I can find that piece at Home Depot. But other than that, yeah, it's my last day of vacation, but still excited about working on the van this morning. And after today, then it's going to be nights and weekends, so the videos will get less frequent for a little bit, but just as exciting, some things coming up to show you. So anyways, all right, let's get started. Just to give you guys a heads up, I actually decided to call the flooring company that I bought the vinyl tile from, just to go over exactly what I need to do and make sure I'm doing everything right. And while I was on the phone with him, he was like, "You sure you don't want us to do it?" And I said, "How much would it cost?" He said, "How big is it?" I said, "It's probably about 6x10. He said, "It'll probably be about $100. And I said, "Can we use your supplies and equipment?" And he said, "Yeah, I think we could do that." So I'm waiting to hear back from them, because if that's the case, because the adhesive itself is like $35. And if that's the case, I can return the adhesive that I bought, the trowels that I bought, all that gear. I probably spent maybe, I don't know, $45 in supplies. And then in essence, you know, I would be paying $55 for the installation, which I can definitely handle. And would definitely be open to that, because number one, I've never done this before, and it would be installed by somebody who knows what they're doing. So I'm waiting to hear back from them, but even on the way, as I'm waiting, we'll go ahead and head to Home Depot and get some of these supplies. It might wind up being that we don't install the floor today if this installer is not available or whatever. But either way, we'll see if I'd like to wait to have them install it. If they can't do it today, we'll probably start working on the windows, which is something I've been waiting to do as well. So, all right, let's get these supplies, and then we'll see what happens if this guy calls me back. Alright, so we're getting ready to do the floor install, and I got a new friend, Robert, here.
Yes,
yes. And Robert works with Wright Flooring, and so he's going to help me professionally install this. He's been doing it for how many years?
Many
years. And so, yeah, it's good to have a professional involved. So,
all right,
well, let's get started. What's the groove on those, that trowel there?
So
Charles. 3 and 32 inches.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And normally I wouldn't even use this trowel, but because of the fact that it's going in this van, and you are gonna probably have things sliding across here from time to time. Mm-hmm. You want the glue to really be able to tack up. Normally I can pick a flat end trowel, like for vinyl or something, and just run a thin skim coat.
Uh-huh.
But because of the fact that you're gonna have things sliding across and up and down it, you know, you want to make sure that it has something to hold on to, and these grooves allow that. But see, this glue right here, it never dries. It stays tacky for years.
Which, that's what allows it to be able to replace planks.
Yeah, the pressure sensitive.
Now I'm seeing some of these little pieces of rocks or something. Do you need to sweep it out?
So again, no, the glue will pull it all down with us.
Okay.
I promise you. And because of the backs of the vinyl, the real minute pieces won't even register.
Okay.
The pebbles will, but you'll be able to grab them as you go. But for the most part, the trowel and the glue will pull it with us.
Okay.
As we come out.
Alright guys, while Robert is working on the flooring, I'm going to kind of go over a little bit about what we're going to do with these windows. And it's actually quite simple. You can see right here we have the window trim that we had already painted. We got some half inch foam right here. We got a product called Glidden Gripper. Okay, you're going to need this because we're going to use this to attach both this canvas that was I pre-washed it. It's just some canvas I bought at Home Depot. I went ahead and washed it, and then I bought these off of Amazon. They're basically emergency blankets, and I think I got six of them for, or how many are there might be eight of them in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, no, I think there's 10. But it was cheap, it was inexpensive. And so what we're going to do, the idea is we're going to cut out a piece of this foam, use the Glidden Gripper on one side, put the Mylar blanket on the other side, put the canvas. And the reason why you want to use Glidden Gripper is because the other types of paints, like spray paint and stuff like that, will actually eat away at the foam. And when I did this with my minivan, I actually used the 3M adhesive spray, because I didn't know what else to use, and it would eat it through. But the canvas, even that, when using the canvas to cover it, you couldn't really see the parts that was eaten through. But the gripper is supposed to be the best stuff to use. So we're going to do that and try to get one of these window inserts finished today. Now what I'm doing is I'm just basically removing some of that magic marker
That permanent marker got a little bit on the trim, so I'm just kind of removing that right now. All right, now when I cut foam, I've learned in the past that using a razor blade actually doesn't work as well as actually using just a regular knife. And this has been one of the tools that I've used with building this camper van that's been invaluable. It's basically just a Leatherman, or should I say Spyderco knife. And it gives you a much smoother cut than a razor blade. So I will begin the first incision. Okay, so the next step is we want to cut out the canvas cloth, and one of the best tools that I found for cutting, especially cutting that radiant, that denim radiant barrier, because it's so tough to cut, is basically just medical shears. These are shears that you would use in a first aid kit to cut clothing off of people. And so I use these a whole lot. So we're going to cut the canvas. And actually, I want to give a nice overlap, because what I want to do is, I don't know if you can see it very well, the sun is so bright, is to actually have maybe about this much overlap. Maybe an inch overlap around the edge. And but we're actually, even though I'm going to cut the canvas first here, we'll actually probably put the foil on first. And now that I've, at this point, I need to make sure that I am putting the right substance on the right side. So this is the way it fits in. And so this side needs to be canvas, and it's got a different curve, so it's not something you could flip around and fit in perfectly the other way around. So this is going to be the canvas side, and the other side will be the foil side. So I'm just going to mark out the canvas, and then, or just cut out the canvas so I have it, and then we'll do the foil side first. I'm just kind of eyeballing it, really. And I'm deciding whether I should leave the seam or cut off the seam. I think I'll try to leave the seam, just because it'll help maybe finish it. Keep it from fraying as well. Okay, so, again, this is going to be the interior. Let's verify again. Always want to verify, re-verify every time you do stuff. Yep. Alright, so that's the interior, set that aside, and now we'll cut out some Mylar blanket, and because it's going to be on the other side, we'll turn it around. And we're probably only going to need to use, because these fold up really, they have a huge surface area, so probably only going to be needing a few of these in actuality. Maybe I'll give some of these away as gifts to other camper builders. And it's probably best to do this in the shade, just because it's so reflective You just want to get it all folded up here. Like a giant piece of sturdy aluminum foil. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put this on top of it so I can see. And this is going to have some we're going to want to do some overlap on this side as well. And then, again, just kind of eyeball it and cut it out. Hope you guys are being able to see this. Or it might be easier on this, because you could slide it, probably. In fact, I'll probably get some regular scissors here for the next one. All right, now again, let's reconfirm which side is which. I'm pretty sure that it has to go like that. That's the right way. And so we need to glue it like this. So we need to glue this side to there, like that. Let's go check on Robert and see how he's doing here. How's it going, Robert?
Yeah, man, it's coming together. Everything's falling into place.
So is it just like doing a regular house, or there's different techniques
the holes, but I mean, you know, it's just a little extra work, but it ain't really, you know, game changing.
Right. What's the secret of laying vinyl planks?
Try to get it right the first time.
Exactly.
Try to get it right the first time.
That's awesome.
All right, now it's coming together.
Good, good. Yeah, his name's Richard. I don't know if I said Robert earlier too, but it's Richard. All right, let's continue working on our little window project here. Okay. So I'm going to get the Glidden gripper now and get this kind of going. And to be honest with you, this is the first time I've used this product. And I learned about this product through a foam construction method that I saw off of Into the Mystery 13. How they use Glidden gripper and fiberglass screen with foam boards to create cabinets and stuff like that, which is what we're going to do also for our cabinets and our countertop. We're going to try to do something very similar. And again, why this is necessary is because just having Reflectix on your windows will help reflect some of that sunlight, but my experience is it turns that Reflectix material, bright sun will turn that Reflectix material into a radiator, and it'll just radiate that heat back into your van. So this foam prohibits the heat from coming back in. And then by putting canvas on the other side, it's just you can do vinyl or something else. How's it going?
You must be Ian.
Yes, I am.
Hi, nice to meet you. I'm Robert.
Robert, nice to meet you.
Good to meet you, sir.
He's doing a great job.
Yeah, Rick does fantastic work. That's why I wanted to get him on it.
Right.
Everything he touches turns to gold, it seems. So.
Well, I'm real happy with Luis.
Yeah.
Spending time making it right.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He'll get it right for you. But, you know, with this style of plank, you may have a pattern repeat in it. You know, I mean, there's
yeah, well, I was noticing that there was.
Well, for instance, like this pattern kind of looks similar if you're really looking for it. They're on different places of the plank, and it's just the way that they roll them and make that you know, color. So you may see it from time to time. Hello.
I think that's empty.
Yep. Sure is.
We have enough?
We're close. Yeah, there's a couple pieces still in here too, so it should be alright. An animal, Richard.
Try to get it down nice and smooth. And one of the things I use a lot is, I guess I could use mineral spirits, but I'm using this I guess I probably should use mineral spirits. I'm using rubbing alcohol to get paint off of me.
No problem.
Man, Rick, you got more small cut pieces here than I've seen ever anywhere.
Uh-huh.
So you got more small cut little pieces than I've ever seen anywhere.
I think you have more waste on this than you got ever did yesterday.
Now to make sure that aluminum mylar is on there completely, I've got to use a roller. And I guess you could buy, there's rollers you can buy at Home Depot, but I have this, so I'm going to just use this.
I didn't want to take it from what you were doing.
Just go around the edges, pull those edges in. Trying to keep paint off of everything.
change that blade is doing that.
Oh yeah, no, I know it.
Well, that one?
Yeah.
I didn't do that. That was before I got here. Yeah. I'm positive.
Alright, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put the canvas on. And we're actually going to do the same thing where we cover it, wrap it around the edges. So, I don't think there's a good or bad side. Just set it right here. Put that on there. Actually, at this point, I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use some 3M adhesive spray because it's to wrap this around, because the Mylar won't melt, or it shouldn't melt. I don't think it'll melt, and it'll be easier clean, because I'm afraid I'm going to get too much of this Glidden Gripper on the foil, and I don't want that. So I'm going to try some 3M spray. All right, so some 3M rubber and vinyl. Actually going to spray some on the foil as well. All right, so we'll let this dry for 3 minutes. Then we'll wrap that around, trim it up, and that should be good for our first window insert. All right, so let's put this, wrap this canvas on here. I think it's dry enough. And again, I'm going to use the ultimate tool, a rolling pin. Get it as smooth as possible. There we go. Pull these corners, or pull the sides first. I think what we'll do is we'll do the corners last and trim them. Sometimes I don't quite know what to do with the corners. I don't want to have a whole bunch of fabric.
Thank you.
Just use some spray to help seal these joints.
Because of the pressure sensitive glue, the more you step on it, the evener the floor will get for you over time.
Okay.
And all these little variations that you're seeing, well, that I see and know are there every time, they go away over time.
Okay.
Weight, traffic.
All right, guys. Well, the floor is finished. I am happy. It looks really good. And I think they did a good job, especially with doing all those cutouts. I know it wasn't an easy thing to do, but looks good. Seems real solid. It's definitely made the floor seem more as a cohesive unit. And we'll just jump in here and take a look. I don't know if you can see, but looks pretty good. Okay, so just give you an idea of what's going on with these holes. This is towards the front of the van. These are just going to be some bolt down areas that I can use to bolt down the countertops that are going here and the cabinets. That's going to be the vent for allowing air to vent in for the refrigerator. So air can vent in and cool the refrigerator. This is going to be a drain hole for the sink. Some more bolt down areas for countertops if needed. Back here is going to be a cable chase. So if I need to send cables from one side to the other of the van, I'll be able to go from there and come out over here. Right here, these holes are to bolt down the batteries. And underneath this is not foam. This little square piece right here is actually a piece of plywood. And seat base bolts, another seat base. And over here is the hole for the porta potty vent. And then this is potential pee pee drain. So that gives you a little idea of what we're expecting. So I'm gonna try to get the seat bases in, and also I've been working on the showing you a window insert, so we can actually put that in. I forgot to put these down. All right, this insert seems to be dry. So it looks good. All right, let's put it in. All right, so here's the door, and here's the trim panel that goes to this door. And I don't think there's anything else I need to install in here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and push it on. And it clips on with these little plastic pieces. So there's actually no bolts.
How does the window thing insert? Does that insert first? Yeah, put that inside?
Nope, it inserts after we get this on. A matter of pushing it on. Okay. And now for our window insert. Again, it only goes in, there's one particular way, foil side out. Wham. Bam. Awesome. And so it's actually just a little bit loose than what I would totally like, but I'm good with it. In terms of, there's a little bit of an air gap right here. But I think it'll work. So you can see that even with the foil, you can't see any foil, partly because of the the limo tinting, and also because it's not totally pressed up against the window. And the advantage of having that foil is that limo tinting does not reflect heat. It actually absorbs heat because it's so dark. So hopefully that will stop a lot of that heat coming into the van. So it's just a matter of doing that for each of those windows. And it makes it look nice. So, and what you can also do is you basically have a thumbtack board if you wanted to. You can just thumbtack stuff, notes, whatever you want, right up there. And then when you don't need it, you can just take it out, store it away. It's solid. Put it back in. Very cool. So also, it's not just for summertime use. A lot of times in the winter, you're gonna lose a lot of heat from inside of your van out through the glass. And so what this does is it keeps the heat in the wintertime inside the van. So, looks good. I love the colors. I love the contrast. I'm happy with it. Hope you like it. Okay guys, well it's close to quitting time, and so I'm gonna start cleaning up, but you can kind of see we've got a little bit of an example here for you. Got the porta potty right here, got the couch, and it looks pretty good. It's a little dark. I'll probably come back in here the next couple days and show you. But really like the window inserts, look really great, and color wise it looks really good too. You can kind of see a little bit of the effort. I would say that having those professional installers do the floor was a win-win, because I don't think I would have been able to do it. I definitely wouldn't have been able to complete it today. And they got it done, and it looks really good. So, all right, well, I'm gonna start cleaning things up, and next time I'll be able to work on the van might be one of the weekday evenings after work. If not then, hopefully Saturday I'll be able to put in a full day. So, all right. Looking good. Finally seeing some visual progress and really excited about it.